Hello everybody and welcome to another edition of the ED Exit video. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to change a G-tube.
So this balloon is not inflated right now?
No, you can just pull it out. There's okay. Nothing there. I'm surprised it stayed in. But I do think some of her seizure medicine was leaked out. This is going to be interesting.
Yeah,
you can look at Nikki's replacement on the website. Does it look
Nikki? Yeah. Uh-huh. And see, the balloon is actually torn right here.
So this is why it malfunctioned. The balloon actually broke right there. And then it just deflates, and then something to hold it comes out. It's wear and tear. Oh. Like I was saying, it's a wheel of a car or a balloon or anything that's mechanical can break over time.
Yeah, we had one feeding tube in less of 2 years almost.
Really?
It got pretty icky, like we're
gonna
take that in, that's too long.
So for the procedure and for the teaching that we're doing, we always want to replace it with the same size or maybe even a little bigger size. You never want to go smaller unless you don't have anything else, or unless it's a difficult insertion. So 20 French, 20 French,
okay.
And you can see the colors change because over time.
Ew.
It just changes colors and stuff like that. This eventually moves in.
Did you give her formula this morning?
A little
bit. Oh, that's what that is then, isn't it? That's formula?
So this little thing here moves around, and the reason that moves, once we inflate this, we pull back like that, and that creates a seal. All right. When it's brand new, it has this little holes on it, and then they use this to put sutures through it and hold it to the skin until it's matured enough. I always go ahead and lock this up so you don't get like gastric juices coming through the tube while you're doing the procedure. And then this is where we go in to put the saline so that the balloon inflates. Kind of like a Foley catheter, you always want to test it to make sure there's no leakage before you go in. So you put some saline in and make sure that everything's mechanically correct with the tube. And that's nice and hard. And we take all that saline out. So that's the big water balloon that's going to be in there once we introduce it. And then it's simple. You just put some steady pressure till you're in. And you push it as far as you want. The stomach is big.
Okay.
So there's plenty of space for things to move around. It's not like we're going to go through and through the stomach or whatever.
Yeah, that was
And we go ahead and inflate the balloon all the way in.
Okay, Nikki.
And we pull back. And that's where I meet the resistance.
Okay.
And now we pull the this in.
That hole doesn't get too large after.
And now it doesn't move.
Okay.
It's in place. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to have the extra people come in and is that the gastrographing? So this is just fluid with gastrographing. It's a radiodense material for when we do the x-ray. And one thing we should do is aspirate. There's gastric contents coming through the tube. And then we go ahead and push. And then when we do the x-ray, it's just going to show that.
Maybe that one.
You may.
I have to order some more skinnier like
that. No, we got to wash it or something.
Oh, that's
alright. And that's it. The tube is replaced now. There's no special gauzes or anything like that. We just put things to absorb whatever's around it. And so whatever normal care you used to do, that's still the same. It doesn't change.
Doctor, is there any pain with a feeding tube ever associated with it? No.
In this x-ray, you can see that the
gastrographic
is indeed in the stomach. You can see actually a silhouette of the tube with contrast on it, so we know in the right place and patient's fine to use the tube. I hope you enjoy this video and learn how to replace a G-tube and how to confirm placement.